hope you're all keeping safe and well. Right, so this video is going to be a little bit different. What I'm doing, I'm going to be test rust running this locomotive for an old pal of mine, 80 Pullen. I met up with him a few weeks back over at the Didcot Railway Centre, and we had a long chat about, well, all things railway. And so he's lent me this J70 along with the Hatton's six-wheel Genesis coach. Yes, it's a lovely detailed locomotive. It's very tiny and it's very delicate, especially when I had to put in the 6-pin decoder, because obviously I'm DCC and 80 is analog. And I said, you do realize, 80, I've got to take this apart to actually physically run this on my layout. And he was quite happy with this. And I was a bit nervous about lending this locomotive from him. So anyway, it's had a test run. It's had a 20 minute in either direction test run. What can I say now? It was very delicate taking this body off its chassis. On the top there you got that very delicate bell, and it only takes one slip and you could quite easily break that, especially when you're taking this apart. And you've got the cow catchers on the front. I don't know if you can see that. I just see that. I know 80's already done a review on this locomotive, so if you want to see the full review, go and check it out. But I won't be doing a review. All I will be doing is just running it on the layout. I've got a couple of jobs lined up for it. There's a traction engine that needs picking up and bringing back to Newcastle over at South Shields, so you can do that. And then we'll have a little run out to Jarrah Road to pick up a 12 ton van, and we'll bring that back to Newcastle. So we shall see how this fares on the track work here with all the crossovers and points. So yeah, let's give it a run out. Right, so here we are, back where we started. Yeah, quite an impressive little runner, considering the size of the motor that's in there. But one thing I did notice when I took it apart, that this top section here, there's a lot of lead weight in here. All that mortar that you can see through these windows, if I can just zoom in there, it's all lead weight. Just can't get the camera to zoom in close enough, but yeah, it didn't quite like the insulated crossover. It's probably because the wheels are so close together. So yeah, it's but apart from that, it's all the other points and crossovers, no problem whatsoever. Same with the Genesis coach. Sometimes I have problems with these six-wheeled milk vans there, but yeah, no trouble at all. So thank you, Eddie, for the loan. I will get this back to you as soon as possible, and I will test it and make sure it still runs on analog before I put it back on the box. But yeah, so I hope you've enjoyed this video, and thanks again for watching. Bye for now.